Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى يراؤون الناس ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا وقال تبارك وتعالى فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراؤون وعن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال بحسب امرئ من الشر أن يشار إليه بالأصابع في دين أو دنيا إلا من عصمه الله أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Dear brothers and sisters, first of all, inshallah, I would request all the brothers who are sitting, you know, in the corners to come closer, inshallah, and join, you know, in the first and second or third or wherever you find place, inshallah. When you pray, you get more reward, you know, if you are in the first line or the second line or the third line, especially on Fridays, you know, the virtues of the Fridays. I recited two ayahs from the glorious Quran. One is from Surah An-Nisa, and the other ayah is from Surah Al-Ma'un. And a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayhi has collected this hadith in his collections. These two ayahs and this hadith talk about riya. Riya means show off, that you show. What show off? If you are an alim, you like to be known as alim. If you are a muhaddith, you become happy when people call you muhaddith. If you are a speaker, you feel very happy when they call you a big speaker. If you have wealth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, has blessed you, and you spend it generously. So you feel happy when you are being called generous. Or anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with, and then you spend it, or you show your generosity through that blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the theme of these two ayahs and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, in the light of the hadith and the stories from the Sahaba, I will try to explain that riya, show off, even if it is little, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that this is shirk. And this is one of the hadith which I recited. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu is the narrator of the hadith. And he narrates from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam where he said, أنه قال بحسب امرئ من الشر أن يشار إليه بالأصابع. That it is evil enough for a man to have fingers pointed at him for some reason. في دين, either it is the matter of deen, of dunya, or it is the matter of dunya. Illa man asamahullah, there is exception except those people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them from that thing. The hadith is very simple, my brothers and sisters. But the word or the phrase an yushara ilayhi bil asabi', that the fingers are appointed at him. Why? Because people are discussing that, you know, this man, he's a big alim, he's a big mufti, he's a big speaker, he's a big orator. He's the one, if he speaks, then thousands of people, you know, come and listen to him. He's generous, he's this, he's this. My brothers and sisters, bihasbi imri'im min ash-sharri. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is evil enough for that man that the fingers are appointed to him. When we talk about religion, so I gave you some examples that he hadha alim, hadha abid, hadha sakhi, hadha this, that this is this, this is this. Also, on the other hand, many times you see that people, they innovate a lot of things in religion. And because of that, they become famous. No, there is the fatwa of that person, of that alim, that he says that if you go to any place, and you can say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim on the chicken or on the meat, and no matter if how it has been slaughtered, you just say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and eat. Or there is one way that you can, call people for a gathering, and you are doing a lot of innovations in that. You are committing bid'ahs. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "An yushara ilayhi bil asabih fi dinim." Either he is doing good, but still people are appointing at him that he is a big alim. And why it is bad, my brothers and sisters? Because when he heard you saying that he's a big alim, he's a big imam, or he's a big mufti, or he's a sakhi, or this and that, so that thing might leave such feeling in his heart that he would be feeling proud of that. And that is the thing that will protect, or he will stay away from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be famous in this worldly life, but in the hereafter he will be deprived of the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aw dunya. Or he's famous in worldly life, in this worldly life, for anything, whatever. And you can see that he's a big leader, he's a big this thing, he's this. And you see that they are not fulfilling the rights of other human beings. They would be killing people, they would be cursing others, they would not be following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would not be following any command of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he is a big man. So fi dinin aw dunya, that he is appointed, or as people are pointing their fingers at him because of their religious reasons, or dunya, or worldly reasons. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, bihasbi imri'in min ash-sharri, it is evil enough for such man that the fingers are pointed to him by people in religious matters or dunya matters. Illa man asamahullah. There are exceptions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless some people that fame, that they become famous. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them in a situation that they become famous because of that incident or that event or whatever conditions they are. Because of that, they become very famous and people come to know about such people. So this is completely from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can protect from that thing, and that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, illa man asamahullah, except whom Allah protects. That if Allah protects him, he will be saved. Otherwise, he will be questionable. I would like to narrate a hadith, and in the hadith, actually, Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu is the narrator of that hadith. He says that one day he went to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He went there and he saw Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, that he was sitting there and he was crying. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu saw Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu sitting by the side of the qabr, of the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he was crying. فَقَالَ مَا يُبْكِيكَ. Umar radiyallahu anhu asked him, O Mu'adh, what is that thing that is making you cry, or you are weeping? What is that thing? Why are you doing it? قَالَ يُبْكِينِي شَيْءٌ سَمِعْتُهُ مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمِ. He said that there is a thing that is making me cry. And the thing is, that is what I heard from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولَ. I heard him saying, إِنَّ يَسِيرَ الرِّيَاءِ شِرْكٌ. That a little showing off, a little riya is shirk. وَإِنَّ مَنْ عَادَى لِلَّهِ وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ بَارَزَ اللَّهَ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ. And if there is anybody who has enmity, hatred, or nifaq, or he's a adi of a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody who worships Allah, somebody who is a close friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you have enmity towards him, that means فَقَدْ بَارَزَ اللَّهَ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ. He has gone forth to wage war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, when we look at our condition, we believe in Allah, we believe in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we pray five times a day, we give zakah, we do everything. But where we stand at this point, what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking, وَمَنْ عَادَى لِلَّهِ وَلِيَّ. If somebody has enmity towards the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means he has gone forth to wage war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means that we should not have that nifaq or that hatred or that enmity in our heart, which we have towards our brothers or sisters or to any big alim or to any imam or to any leader or to any chairman of of the masajid or madaris or institutions, because you never know. Somebody might be hidden and you might be looking at him down. You might be looking him down that he's, just of no value. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about that. And at the end of this hadith, I would like to narrate a story. And that is a very beautiful story, my brothers and sisters. And this is one of the sahabi, Hudair, radiyallahu anhu. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, "Inna Allaha yuhibbul abrar." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves three types of people. He mentioned that. Al-abrar, al-atqiya, and al-akhfiya. These are three types of people. Or people who have these three qualities, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. Al-abrar, these are the people that, they are always busy in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they always follow his commands. They do good deeds, performing righteous deeds. And al-atqiya, they fear Allah. They have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever they are doing in their worldly life, always they are conscious. They have that consciousness or the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is watching them. Either it is their prayer, their generosity, their dealing with other human beings, or they are, spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are doing their business. They are doing their, or they're working or leading their daily life. At every step, they watch that Allah subhanahu, they see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching them. So these are the atqiya. And al-akhfiya, this is one word which is very important for all of us. Akhfiya is the plural of khafi. And khafi means hidden or unknown. Nobody knows about that. And that is the story related to the sahabi, Hudair radiallahu anhu. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Allah yuhibbul abrar al-atqiya al-akhfiya." Who have these three qualities, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. Alladhina idha ghabu lam yuftaqadu. When they disappear, they are not present, nobody looks for them because they are not known among people. Wa idha hadaru lam yud'u. When they are present, people ignore them. They don't call them, okay, you come. Or when they are present, people won't call them to their majalis, to their gatherings, because he doesn't have any value, or is that man, nobody knows him. Wa idha hadaru lam yud'u. وَلَمْ يُعْرَفُوا. And they are not recognized at all. قُلُوبُهُمْ مَصَابِحُ الْهُدَى. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking about their hearts. Their hearts are the lamps of guidance. That means that because of the light of their hearts, they save their deen, and they are the close friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَصَابِحُ الْهُدَى يَخْرُجُونَ مِنْ كُلِّ غَبْرَاءَ مُظْلِمَةٍ. That is the thing that saves them from all the storms of baddeen, or the things that deviate human beings from their deen or from their religion. My brothers and sisters, there is a word akhfiya, khafi, is the singular of akhfiya, that means hidden and unknown. And that's the story I'm going to narrate, inshallah. Ibn al-Jawzi, rahmatullahi alayhi, was a big scholar. He was a faqih, he was muarrikh, he was a big orator, he was a big musannif, a big writer. And he has, ulama have mentioned that he has written more than almost about 300 books. And there is one about a very famous book, Sifatul Safwa, in which he's mentioning the story of a sahabi. And the sahabi's name is Hudair Radi Allahu Anh. So from the book, he mentions that one time, and he narrates this from Ibn Umar Radi Allahu Anh, where he said that one time the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sent a jaysh. Jaysh means an army, that he was sending them somewhere for some reasons, or you know, to defend themselves or whatever was the reason. And among that army there was a man, and he was known as Hudair. And the year the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sending that army was not good for these people, for the Sahaba or those people in the army. That was not because of the Shidda, or because they were lacking food, things to drink, and you know, they were facing a hard time in that year. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you know, put them in order, and he provided the provision, the zad, for their traveling, because they would be traveling, they will be defending or fighting, and they will need, you know, food, drink, or whatever they need. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave to everybody except one person. He forgot him. And it was Hudair radiallahu anhu. Hudair kept quiet. He didn't say anything. He was sabir. He kept patient. And he applied that patience at that time. He was going the path of Allah to defend himself, to fight against the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not giving him anything. He's just, you know, empty-handed. No food, no drink, nothing. Okay, that's fine. Hudair radiallahu anhu, at the end of the line of the army, kept quiet, and he started reciting few words. And inshallah, I would like to mention those words. يَقُولُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. These were some of the words that he was repeating when he, you know, was put in that condition. وَيَقُولُ نِعْمَ الزَّادْ هُوَ يَا رَبْ. These are also the words he was repeating with لا إله إلا الله. Allahu Akbar, walhamdulillah, wa subhanallah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Ni'ma zad huwa ya rab. Fahuwa yuraddiduha wa huwa fi akhir. That he was repeating those words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and sisters, knows what is going on, what is seen and what is unseen. Nobody knew about Hudair radiallahu anhu, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was seeing him. The condition he had, or he was in, his situation, that he was sabir and he was not telling anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, that you forgot a man. You gave provision to everybody, but you forgot that man. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, when he got Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he called a person and he sent him that this is the provision for Hudair, and you take to him. And when you reach him, just listen what he's saying or what he's repeating. And when you give that provision which I'm giving you, when you give that thing to him, also listen to him carefully. What is he repeating or what is he reciting? The man appointed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go there, he reached there. And he said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to you. Yaqra'uka assalam wa rahmatullah. وَيُخْبِرُكَ أَنَّهُ كَانَ نَسِيَ, that he is informing you that he forgot you. وَإِنَّ رَبِّي تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَرْسَلَ إِلَيَّ جِبْرِيلَ, and my Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam to me. يُذَكِّرُنِي بِكَ, that he's reminding me about you. فَذَكَرَهُ جِبْرِيلَ عَلَيْهِ صَلَاتُ وَسَلَامُ وَأَعْلَمَهُ مَكَانَهُ. So the Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam now is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the makan, the status of that hidden man, that unknown man, nobody knew about him. But Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam that you forgot a man who is not known among people, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about him. فَانْتَهَا إِلَيْهِ, that man went to him, to Hudair radiallahu anhu, وَهُوَ يَقُولُ, and he was reciting those words, لَا يَقُولُ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهُ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَيَقُولُ نِعْمَ الزَّادْ هُوَ يَا رَبُّ. He was saying those words. This brother went there and he said whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him to do, and he heard him saying those words, and he memorized those words, and then he came back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَأَخْبَرَهُ بِمَا سَمِعَ مِنْهُ حِينَ أَتَاهُ وَبِمَا قَالَ حِينَ أَخْبَرَهُ. when he went there and when he, you know, informed him about the forgetfulness of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he, you know, told him everything. So he heard him saying all those words. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to know that he was repeating those words, he was saying those words, he said, "Ama innaka law rafa'ta ra'saka ila as-sama'." If you would have raised your face or you would have looked into the sky, you would have, he said, لَرَأَيْتَ لِكَلَامِهِ ذَلِكَ نُورًا سَاطِعًا بَيْمَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. You would have seen a noor, a light that was spread in between the sama, between the heaven and the earth. My brothers and sisters, this was Hudair radiallahu anhu. After mentioning this, Ibn al-Jawzi, rahmatullahi alayhi, comments on that نَسِيَتْ تَارِيخُ حُدَيْرًا. Tariq, the history forgot Hudair radiallahu anhu. وَنَسِيَ أَنْ يَحْفَظَ لَنَا إِسْمَ أَبِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ. And the tariq, the history forgot to, you know, record the name of his father, of his mother. وَمِنْ أَيِّ قَبِيلَةٍ هُوَ. From which part or which qabila, which tribe he was from. وَفِي أَيِّ عَامٍ وُلِدَ. Which year he was born. وَفِي أَيِّ عَامٍ مَاتَ. And which year he died. وَكَيْفَ مَاتَ. How he died. لَكِنْ رَبَّهُ لَمْ يَنْسَ. But his Lord did not forget him. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ لَا يَنْسَى أَوْلِيَاءَهُ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forget his people who are very close to him, who are his friends. My brothers and sisters, this is the story of Hudair radiallahu anhu. And the lesson, the important lesson for all of us, that anything which we have in our life, if our intentions are not good, they might not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever we have in our life, or whatever we are doing, that should be for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many other hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talk about the same theme and the same topic. And this is one of the hadith where he said, "Man talaba ad-dunya halalan, mufakhiran, mukathiran, mura'iyan, laqiya Allah wa huwa alayhi qadban." Whoever acquires this worldly thing, seeks worldly things through in a lawful way, that his way is lawful, is allowed in Islam, but he has a wish that he feels proud of that, and he wants to acquire more and more, too much, and he wants to show off, that person will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a state that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be angry with him. And وَمَنْ طَلَبَ الدُّنْيَا. One who seeks dunya, this world. How? Halalan, in a halal way. Isti'afafan, anil mas'ala. He stays away from begging. Wasa'yan ala iyali. And he's making efforts, striving, so that he can fulfill the duties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigned him towards his ayal, towards his family members, his wives and children, parents or anybody. Wata'attufan ala jari. And he is very kind towards his neighbors. لَقِيَ اللَّهَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَوَجْهُهُ كَالْقَمَرِ لَيْلَةَ الْبَدْرِ. That he will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the state that his face will be as bright as you see the full moon. My brothers and sisters, there are many other hadith or narrations that you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking about, you know, about the same theme and subject. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds, our words. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us if we have anything like riya or shawf or pride in our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us and cure us from all these types of disease which we might have in our life. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. There are different requests for those people who are sick or those who are, you know, who passed away. Also, there are a lot of requests from brothers and sisters to pray for the Muslims in Central Africa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them strong and firm on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in belief in His oneness. Also, there is a request for mother-in-law of Brother Musa Warachia. She is in hospital. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her shifa ajla mustamirra daima. Keep in your du'as all the brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa to all those people who are sick. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all those people who passed away and make things easier for all of us. Wa akhru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have 5 minutes for sunnah.